di times ko mag-Bisaya alam ta. So, oh, this is not the one. We will go first with the other Google Classroom. Katujong ato ano. This one is intended for my, the other account is intended for my students sa CSR.
Pero dapat ano, sasabihin mo kay mama mo, may naawit ka.
O, ba't hindi siya? Sasabihin kay mama.
Okay. So, again, no, you will visit your Google Classroom, HM1C Macro Perspective. For those who are not yet part of our Google Classroom, this is the Google Classroom code. And I will, this is the link, no, pero ang nai-access ani ang teacher. Please go here if you want to answer the activity. I haven't posted it yet. Please do not be confused pa as to why there is no activity posted in the stream. This is where I will post, diba, katong mga activities, mga slides. So, ang slides, pag September 1, last week, ako na siyang nahatag sa inyo, ha? If you cannot see it here, you can go to classwork. As of now, I haven't made anything yet, just the getting to know you activity, but after our session or our instructions tonight, I will upload the activity for you to answer. Since most of you were able to attend my classes, katong continuation no, sa lesson 1 and then ang lesson 1 itself after the orientation, then you'll be able to answer the activity. So, sa katong wala naka-attend sa classes, two meetings na dyan siya wala naka-attend, they have to watch the orientation and lesson 1 part 1 video first, 1 hour and 41 minutes na siya, and lesson 1 part 2, which is atong pag-last September 1, before sila maka-answer, because some questions there, ang answers ana is can be found from the discussion that I already did last week and last 2 weeks ago pa no kay two meetings man ta ato sa lesson 1. Now, I'll give you an example in the POV of the student. So ning repeat lang ko ani ha, na discuss na ko ni siya last time sa inyo ha, nagrepeat lang ko og discuss so that sa katong naka nakalimot na makarmember sila. So, we will see in the POV of the student. I will use this stream because makita naman ano, our teacher is Sister Cleofe, but in my case, you will see here, Cybel and Ramirez posted a new assignment. So, muna na siya. No, that means that you will be able na to access the activity and answer it. Or you can go to classwork. Okay, so muna na siya. Kita ni mo dira ang instructions, pero wala instructions sa ka-post. And then, you click the activity itself. So, in here, I'll give you an example of Section A. Section A and Section D, natapos ko na checking. Tonight, I will check Section 1B. Naka-start na ko sa B, pero I haven't finish half of it yet. I really read your responses. Class ha, gabasa gid ko sa inyong responses. So, may ibang gani nga, balik-balik na ang ilahang lesson D nga, oh, letter D, lesson 1 nga answers, pero sige na lang, tagaan na to, 3 points or pila ka points. So, kanina ay mga na-late o submit, that's why turned in, na ay 6 nga, wala pa naka-answer, 38 graded na. So, this is what you will see. Once you open your Google Classroom, this is the activity that you will see with the instruction. Please do not open this activity in Google Docs and edit it there. Do not open the activity and edit it. You have to download it offline if you're using your laptop or computer. If lang ha, if you're using laptop and computer. Pero if you're using your cell phone, there is also another way to do this. Later on, I will explain. So, if you're using PC or laptop or tablet, you can download this activity. Please do not open with Google Docs and edit it, because ang matabuan na class, kung i-edit ni mo ni siya, dili japon ni siya masubmit as an activity. You just edited the empty template, meaning ang kaning template nga kung gi-upload, imorang gi-update by editing it, pero dili siya masubmit under your name as your submission. Murarag ka nang gi-edit ra po nimo ang template ba dayon makita sa imong ubang mga classmates. Okay, so dapat i-download nimo siya offline. To do that, if you're using laptop, computer, or tablet, you click open in your window. Don't worry sa mga nagamit og cellphone, maghatag kog separate instruction how to do yours, nga dili mo kinahanglan na mag-download. May iban man nga cellphones na asalay applications where they can view documents, di ba? Like WPS or Kingsoft or Word mismo. Microsoft Word mismo. No? You can do that. You can edit a file. Pero there are times nga kung gamit kag cellphone, dili man nimo ma-upload ang file balik sa Google Classroom. So mahatag og separate ana nga instruction. So kani para lang sa usa ni sa gagamit og CP. Okay. Please wait for a while. I will finish my discussion and then I will be entertaining your questions. So for now, this is an instruction for laptop and PC. So once nag-open ka, pwede man open in Google Docs pero imong i-download. And then pwede pod open in new window. Then what you will do is you will download the document. Okay? Download mo na siya. Kita mo na siya diri. So wait mo lang siya matapos siya download. So dili nimo i-edit ang file online. You have to really download it. Wait lang kay maghatag ko instruction kung unsaon siya sa cellphone. Hulata lang sa nga mahuman ko sa PC o laptop nga instruction. So kung gamit kag PC or laptop, pwede mo na siya ma-edit. WPS man ang gigamit ko. So pwede mo na siya ma-edit sa WPS or sa Microsoft Word. In here, you will change its subject title, THC4 Macro Perspective. Title of the topic presented, Lesson 1, Activity _ Prelim. Okay, this is part of the prelim naman na activity. Then your name. No, i-edit na siya dira. Then date submitted. So for example, if you will submit it tonight or tomorrow, depending on your time, no? And connectivity. So you will answer overview of the topics covered in the session. What you mean about overview is the summary of the entire discussion that you have learned from last week and also from the previous week pa jud kay twice naman ta nag-meet for lesson 1. The next is new learning taken from the activity. What have you learned that is something new to you? Take for example, I learned that there is a difference between excursionist and tourist because I thought nga if mag-travel ka lang, tourist ang tawag sa imuha, pero if dili day ka mag-stay og more than 24 hours, you will be called an excursionist. So that's an example, no? Something that is new nga you only learned during the discussion. The third question, how can you apply this learning to your current situation as a student? So from what we discussed last two meetings, how can you apply all of the things that you have learned to your current situation as a hospitality management student? And then the last one, discuss the significance of the hospitality and tourism industry in the global economy, job opportunities, and importance of customer service. You will be able to answer this one if naminaw mo ato, namati mo atong pag discuss na ko, no, kay I already discussed there what are the advantages of the tourism industry for the economy and how it can provide job opportunities and why is it important to customer service. Then your name lang sa ubos, okay? If you're using your laptop or PC, then you save the file. You can even rename the file to your name, like for example, delacruz_bshm1c. Then, once you save the file, you will upload it in the Google Classroom stream. Now, dili man ako na siya mahimo dire. Din ako siya mabuhat dire because this is in the POV of the teacher. So basically what you're going to do is like similar lang ani no, kani kay POV of the student man. I-click to nimong activity, pero for example mo ni siya ang activity. In your screen this is what will pop out, okay? You will just click add or create. Then click file. Afterwards, you click browse, then upload, upload the file that you edited, no? Wala man ako gi-edit sa kung name, pero i-upload na yung file kati mong gi-edit nga na yung mga answers. You wait for it to load. And then click turn in. What will be the indication that you have successfully turned in your answers or the document? If na nakabutang unsubmit or turned in, past tense na ni turned in, kay nakahuman na ka og submit. Okay? Anyway, I will still comment man japon if wala ko nakakon kay every time that I will check your answers, I will then immediately give you the score. So you will know, no, you will just have to check your Google Classroom if nahuman ako og check, and then you will see your score there out of 40 points. Now let us proceed. What if you will be using your smartphone or cell phone? Simple. If you cannot download the file, all you have to do is just take a photo of the questions. Then if you have notes or notepad nga application in your cell phone, you just place all of your answers there per question. If wala pa jud kay notes man, wala man koy notes nga application sa akong cellphone, pwede man nga isulat nimo sa piece of paper and then picturean mo lang ang piece of paper kung asa dira imong mga answers. Pwede man pud sa notes i-screenshot mo lang. Or ma'am, I can download man the document ma'am kay I have an application sa phone that can view documents. Problem lang, I cannot upload it. Pwede man ka mag-answer sa document imong gi-download sa cellphone if you have a document viewer like WPS or Kingsoft, bang tawag, ano na, I forgot the name. And then you just screenshot also. And then, pwede ra ang screenshot or ang photo sa imong papel nga gisulat, gisulatan, mao ang imong i-upload sa activity. So in here, Word document na, makita ninyo Word document. Word document ang nasubmit. Pwede mampud siya photo. Either screenshot sa imong answers from notes or from the document viewer application sa imong cellphone, or ginpicturean mo ang yellow pad mo nga na dito ang answers nimo sa 4 questions. Pwede man photos, no, kay you will just click upload and then create or upload, and then pwede photos. For example, mo ni siya kung i-upload ng photo abi sa kung answers, just an example ha. Oh, then pwede siya ma-load. You will just wait nga ma-load siya properly, then you click turn in. Okay? Again, successful ra ang pag-submit sa activity if the result will be turned in, meaning past tense ha. College na mo, I know you already know the difference between past tense and present tense. This is present tense. Turn in. So, turned in, past tense, that means nakasubmit ka na. Or, unsubmit ang mugawas. Ngano unsubmit man, kay nakasubmit naman ka, so you have the option to unsubmit the activity. Okay, kay successfully nakasubmit naman ka sa imuhang activity or answers. Okay? And then that's it, no? More naman na siya usually if you're going to send your answers. please, no, dili magtinamaran, magtapulan, ayun to, what other terms you call it, no? Please do not be lazy in using technology to submit your answers. I will only allow if you will email your answers to me if dili na jud makaya, no? Or if mag-struggle ka sa imuhang load, no? Pwede man sa Messenger. Pero again, as much as possible, it's safer to upload it in Google Classroom so that dili malost ang imuhang submissions. As you can see, this will happen if you submit it in Google Classroom. I will basically monitor if you have submitted or not your activity. And if you send it to me through Messenger or email, there are times that your activity will be lost. Okay? So see, turned in, and then my score na siya, 35 over 40. So nakita na dire kani, done late. Kaya wala ko pa na-check. Turned in man siya, pero wala siya naka-turn in gani, getting to know you activity, oh. So makita mo dira. Okay, missing. So things like that, no? We can easily monitor your outputs. So wala jud ingon nga reason nga nunubo ang grade or this and that. Okay? But again, I will give you second options. If di na jud ma-carry, pwede man sa phone, sa Messenger, but you will just have to update me from time to time so that I can record the scores, okay? And that is it. No, I will upload na the activity tonight immediately after this session. Questions? If none, when will be the deadline? It is also available, no, for you to see in your classwork, but usually the deadline will be until tomorrow evening. Oh, kung makita ka man dira, no, due September 6, 6 PM. And then, automatically, maklose ni siya ha, basta if you are late. Pero again, I can understand students if they are having trouble submitting, basta valid lang ang reason. I will immediately know if the student is not telling the truth, no, kaya syempre, murag suspicious naman if almost kuha na jud, no? Almost all nagid ang dili makakomply. So anyway, that is it. Okay? You have time tonight to answer until tomorrow evening pa man ang deadline. Four questions only. Please make time. And please, I am reading your answers. Na times nga na 28 lang akong ginahatag or 30 because I see or I saw nga ang mga inyong answers kay based ra sa gi-Google, gi-chat GPT. I mean, okay man mag-Google basta na uban nga words gikan pod sa inyo ha. Okay? So, I will stop the sharing na, and then I will allow you to